This is the virtual video tour of the Canvas course template. I want to spend a few moments to kind of give you a general overview, a general tour of all 9 elements of the course template, keeping in mind that there are 7 student-facing elements and then 2 that are for teachers only. And so let's kind of begin unpacking that just briefly. So the first element, the first student-facing element is, of course, the landing page, the home page that includes a place for you to do a course banner, a welcome message, and then your 6 content buttons. As you will learn in the template, these buttons are not to be replaced, but you can brand them to match your school color scheming. The second element to the template is the syllabus, and this is where you will have 3 options to choose from. Option 1, where you are going to be embedding a document, slide deck, or whatever that you already currently have of your syllabus. Option 2 includes a link to these specific aspects of your course, and they link out to a module called Welcome to Class. And then the 3rd option is to include all of the same content that you see in option 2, but do it in a linear fashion. You'll be able to revise each of these ribbon to match the color scheme of your school. Now, the key for the syllabus is you choose one option and stick to that one option. The next elements all appear here in the modules. So the first teacher-only module is really the module for you to learn how to use this template. You'll need to read this document first. It will go through all of the specific pieces that follow. The virtual tour, videos to help you customize and build out your landing page, your syllabus, and then learning navigation. You'll see examples from teachers who have implemented this in our pilot program of this template. You will also see design resources to help you. And then, which I think is one of the most important pieces here, is this course template checklist so that you can make sure that you're covering everything you need to. Teacher only module number 2 really helps you to understand how to leverage Canvas for student learning, looking at how Canvas supports blended learning, how to plan and begin with the end in mind by planning a module structure, how to build out or how to understand the different content and assessment tools, how to leverage grading and feedback in Canvas, and then how to get your course ready for students, because there's going to be a lot of things that you'll need to do. And so I've included 2 additional very important checklists here for you, the beginning and end of course checklist, along with the course look fors. These 2 checklists are very important to help you get your course ready. The next element, this is the next student-facing element, and that's the Canvas student orientation. Please read this page first. It will remain unpublished, as you see here. This student orientation covers soup to nuts about Canvas. And the recommendations will provide you with kind of a scope and sequence of how you can use this orientation, all or part. Whatever the requirements you set, just make sure that you're consistent in the way that you roll that out. This module, of course, will eventually be moved to the top as the first module for students. You'll see there are quizzes and assignments and things that they can complete, like getting to know one another, doing an introduction through a meme, to completing assignments, or trying to model the things they're learning, and then actually doing the things to help shore up their understanding of how to use Canvas. Okay, the next piece, this of course is the Welcome to Class syllabus I mentioned earlier, that's connected to the syllabus. If you're not going to use option 2 in the syllabus, you do not need to. You can simply unpublish this module. The next piece is the module template. This is if you are building brand new content. I would recommend that you duplicate this module because it includes module introductions, lesson essential questions, lesson introductions, teacher talk, and it includes all of the learning navigation associated with the specific page or assignment or quiz or discussion requirement. So I encourage you to duplicate those items, duplicate that module template as you see fit, and duplicate any of the specific assessment pieces that you need. Hope that helps. This gives you a kind of a quick tour of the template.